In 1936, it was placed into a trust, and it's been in a trust ever since. And what that means is that the trust has a series of companies that subsidize us during the hard times. And as you know, the newspaper industries have hard times at the moment. But that gives us an editorial freedom, and it gives us the ability to think, I think, a little more long term
Yeah.
than.
Some American newspapers are looking at it as a model.
Yes, they like the idea until they learn that you have to give away your ownership of the paper
Yeah.
to make it work. It is a great idea because it does give you a complete editorial freedom, and it means your only relationship is with your readers. You don't have a proprietor or anybody who can tell you what to think.
Put it in some kind of perspective, as you might say, the Times or other British newspapers.
Well, online, we're now just tucked behind the New York Times as the second biggest English language newspaper in the world. So we've got 37 million unique users, about a third of them in America, a third
A
of the rest of the
third.
world. Third, yeah, we've got about 12 million unique users in
Right.
America, and a third in the rest of the world. So it's pretty big online. It's a progressive, liberal, whatever you like to call it, papers,
On a
which
right to left
on a
spectrum.
right to left spectrum. And I don't know if that is what appeals to some American readers, the fact that that is a paper that has a viewpoint. And it's serious. It's serious and it's international. And I think maybe American readers who feel that some American papers are withdrawing from the world find a paper that's still internationally engaged.
Rupert Murdoch is winning the admiration of some people in his business who might have viewed him a different way because he's had the spirit to move forward and say content's important and you're going to have to pay for it online.
Yeah. Well, good luck to him.
You
I mean,
think
seriously,
you
I mean,
think it's a fool's errand?
well, two different questions. One is nobody has yet done it in terms of general news. It doesn't mean that it can't be done. I think it's a difficult proposition. But seriously, if he can make it work, then that is interesting. I think journalistically, we just need to stop and think, because I think journalistically, I'm not a pessimist. I think what the web has done is miraculous in terms of information, and that newspapers should want to be open and collaborative in what they do, because that's the way the internet works. And so I think it's a very profound statement journalistically to want to put a universal barrier between you and the way the rest of the world is going to work. So it's a kind of sort of it's a journalistic question which I think is fighting to be open, and a business decision that says we want to be closed may not be the right journalistic
Okay, but
answer.
at the same time, people are stepping forward to say free, you know, that there are alternatives to free. And you hear it from people like Eric Schmidt, who's beginning to say things he wouldn't have said 2 years ago.
Well, I heard Schmidt talk last night in Washington, and actually he was using much the same language as I'm using. He was saying you've got to decide who you're competing with and who you're collaborating with. And I think it's more about collaboration at the moment than competition. So to give an example, you've just had someone talking about the environment. The Guardian has six reporters doing the environment, but that's not enough to do the environment in reality. There's great content on the environment out there on the web, and so we went to the 10 or 20 best websites and said, why don't you sit on our platform? That way we get great content, and they get access to this enormous audience. So I think that the collaborative possibilities of the web are the interesting ones.